Hey guys, Bone checking in from the official YouTube studio of Bone Tactical now in our USA-based facility. Okay, we've got YouTube studios we've set up in our various facilities around the world, coming live from sunny South Florida, and I'm going to talk to you today about what women want. Okay, it's a much requested subject. Had a lot of people asking about it, but it's also something that I've really wanted to kind of think about how I want to approach this and why that I'm going to do this. And you know, I do this stuff for you guys, so I'm always looking for some feedback. And the reason that I'm doing this video is because you guys asked me many times about, you know, different dating advice and stuff like that. So I'm going to approach this very carefully because I'm going to come right out and say, first off, I'm a Christian. Okay, I'm not giving you this information so you can go out and take advantage of women, or so you can, you know, manipulate, you know, women into getting a lot of different dates and stuff like that. I hope that you use this information for the good and for finding someone to date responsibly and for getting the attention of a woman that you're into and for dating her, you know, in a respectful manner, treating her with respect. That's my disclaimer. You can use this information any way that you want to use it. But again, I'm not putting this out there so that you can get with a bunch of women, okay? I'll be the first one to tell you I've lived that lifestyle. It's an unfulfilling lifestyle. We always feel like the grass is greener on the other side. It's not. It would be highly beneficial, in my opinion, to live the way God created us, to live with one woman, and I've never done that. I haven't lived that way. I have lived the opposite of that, I guess, in a lot of ways, and I think right now I'm you know, in my 30s and single, and yes, I've, you know, dated a lot, I've been with a lot of women, that whole thing that a lot of popular subculture will tell you is cool, but it's really not that cool. It's an unfulfilling lifestyle. It's something that, you know, might be, you know, a night, one night, two nights, whatever, and then immediately unfulfilling. And then the more you do it, the higher the bounds become, the higher the goals. So, you know, you get what you want out of this one woman, and then it's on to the next and on to the next until you've had all of this stuff that's unfulfilling. You've been with so many women, no matter how beautiful they are, it doesn't matter anymore. If it's multiple women, it doesn't matter anymore. It just, at a certain point, you realize it's unsustainable, okay? You can't do this. You can't do this forever. And it doesn't get any exponentially better. Once you've done the whole models and bottles lifestyle, fast life, that you think is great and cool, at a certain point, you regret it, okay? So I'm gonna start right into it here. There's six things, okay, that women want. And this is universal, all women want this. Most of them are subconscious, so a lot of times women don't even know what they want. As men, we know that, okay? I'm not saying that in a sexist way. Guys don't know what they want either. A lot of our things are subconscious. It's important to know that men are hardwired for sight, okay? Very visually stimulated. Women are not necessarily the same way. They're feelings and touch stimulated much more than men are. So let's go into it knowing that and understanding that about women, that they don't think or feel the same way you do. They don't respond to situations the same way you do. The number one out of six, number one thing women look for is confidence. Okay? Confidence is a game changer. You've got to step forward. You've got to step in with confidence. Women are just stopped in their tracks by a man with confidence. And if you have the other things on this list, it's game over for you. Okay? But obviously, number one is confidence. You've got to be able to step to that woman with the icy cold stare, with the, you know, there's some inappropriate terms for it that are out there, the resting unhappy woman face, okay? You guys probably know the term, but very, very attractive women kind of give off an unapproachable vibe many times, and it's the guy that will approach them with confidence that is always going to get the phone number, get the date, you know, get the get the transaction that you're wanting to get out of this woman. You're going to possibly develop a friendship or whatever you want to develop, okay? Confidence. Step forward with confidence. Now, you can go overboard with confidence because there's a very thin line between being confident and being weird, okay? Girls don't want to get that Chester vibe from you. They don't want to think like, oh my goodness, like, is this guy off his rocker? So you, the next things I'm going to explain to you, the other six things on this list, in hand with confidence, number six is the biggest one. If you just have number one and number six on this list, every time, it's a guaranteed that you're going to have a positive transaction with that woman that you're approaching, okay? But step forward with confidence, guys. Enter the situation with confidence. You got to go 100%. I can relate it to football, athletics, okay? You know, I played defensive line in college. When the ball snaps, if you're going to make a mistake, you got to make that mistake at 100%. When you're going to approach that woman, you can't, there's no stutter step involved, okay? You got to, on the snap of the ball, you got to go, okay? In 100%, if you make a mistake, if you make a, you know, a dumb comment, play it off and just keep going. And the only way that you're going to be able to do that is just to continue with that practice and just do it. Just go out, go to the mall, go to the bar. You know, I'm not going to say go to the bar, okay? Restaurant, social events, things like that. Where you're going to be around a woman that you find attractive and just walk up and make a conversation. It's going to be awkward at first. They're going to be like, why is this guy talking to me? You know, what's going on here? But that's the time when you have to keep talking and find some common ground and make a conversation, introduce yourself, buy them a drink, offer to do something cool with them. Hey, I'm new in the area and I'm, you know, I really enjoy long walks on the beach. Let's hit the beach sometime, whatever. The rest of the stuff is what really plays on that. But with number one rule, having confidence, I'm going to tell you guys this, very important. Just make sure you don't cross that line from being confident into being, you know, stalkerish or super like overconfident nerd. You have to be confident, but you have to also look like you should be confident. Okay. So let's go into part two. Number two thing that women want, and this is kind of, you either have it or you don't. Women want a tall, handsome, muscular guy. Okay. I was blessed genetically to fall into that category. If you weren't, then you're going to have to work harder at the other things. It's not a deal breaker for you, but this is one of the things women want. Why do women want a tall, handsome, muscular, or fit athletic guy? It's a subconscious need, okay? Check out Maslow's hierarchy of needs if you don't understand psychology of the human mind, but it's a need for security. It stems from a subconscious need for security. So women automatically notice that taller and fit guy immediately after they, way before they notice everybody else, they notice that tall, fit guy, and that's just simply because they're a need for security. And that's, you know, a deep, deep-seated human survival trait that we have a need, that we want a need for security. Number three thing is they want a handsome guy, okay? Aside from height and stature, which anybody can be in shape, so it's very important that you are in shape, that you take care of your physical fitness. That's very important if you want an advantage of talking to women. The next thing is handsome, okay? That women want an attractive guy. That's obvious. I'll go briefly on this topic because you either have it or you don't, but being attractive as a guy is all about symmetry. We can look at the science of it, and if your eyes are on the same level, if your ears are a good size, if your nose is, all of this, it's symmetry. We don't really understand, we don't think about that on a conscious level. It's all symmetry. So you're either beautiful or you're not, and women are, just like anyone else, immediately noticing that guy right up front that's handsome. It's not a deal breaker if you're not handsome, guys. Stay tuned and I'll show you some other things that can 100% make up for not being handsome. And number six and number one, like I told you, with those two things, you can kill your dating game. Women like a guy that's exotic as well as handsome. So when it comes to beauty and being handsome as a man, girls are looking at symmetry, but they're also looking at an exotic nature, okay? If you're tan, if you're maybe something that they haven't seen before. Being bilingual is a big thing. So I speak Spanish as well. And if I go out and I get the sense that a woman is speak that a woman can speak Spanish. I can walk up to her and start speaking to her in Spanish, and because I look so Caucasian to Hispanic women, it's just a huge ice and immediately boom, and she wants to know more about me. Where did you learn Spanish? That's amazing. Da 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 da. And it's, I mean, I can exchange phone numbers within 5 minutes. The whole thing with that. So guys, learn another language. And yes, learning another language will make you more handsome to women because it makes you exotic, okay? Even can make up with not being, make up for not being handsome a little bit because you can act like you're not from here. Just kidding, don't lie to women, okay? It's very easy to get caught up in the whole lying thing. It almost would seem like many women want you to lie to them. They don't want you to lie to them. It's not something that is also gonna benefit you in the long run. You're gonna have to get caught on those lies if you try to continue that relationship any further, and anything built on lies is gonna crumble. So don't lie to women. Build yourself up, learn another language, and actually do some things that are gonna help you, and then you won't have to lie to women. Number four, women want a man that is a provider and a protector. Okay, and this also stems back to the caveman mentality of our human basic nature, which we all like to think that we're better than, especially us as Christians. We like to think that we don't give in to that sin nature or that basic human nature, but we do, and it's just part of us, and we have to understand it, get away from it as much as we can as intelligent beings, but it's still part of us, okay? So women want that man who's a protector and a provider. One of the ways that they look for that is through items like this, a fancy watch, okay? Oh, wow, he's got a fancy watch. He's very well-dressed. He drives a nice car. That's one of the biggest reasons why women know men's brands, okay? Oh, that's a $300 shirt that he's wearing. Why do they know that? They don't really care. It's subconscious level. They think that that man can provide for me. That man can protect me, especially in today's times. Money to a woman is their conscious way of saying women consciously look for a man who looks like he has money as a provider because they also think that that man can give protection. It's not necessarily true, okay? So on a deeper subconscious level, all women are looking for a man who can protect them. So let's talk a little bit more about protection. How can you show a woman that you can protect her? So even if you don't have money, you can still hit this provider and protector tab. The synapses will fire for that woman and she'll link you with being a provider and a protector even if you don't have money. How can you do that? Okay. You carry a knife. You know how to use the knife. You're a skilled martial artist. Okay. You carry self-defense tools. Okay. Something comes up. Let me give you this example. So I am in Auburn, Alabama. I have a condo there, and I was hanging out at the pool, and the pool at my condo happens to be one of the hottest pools in the whole city. So there's just girls everywhere, college girls, every day. And I go there, and it's a little awkward for me. I go there to relax, get some sun, I work out, and then hit the pool on, some of my off times. You guys have seen the videos. There's actually a video, I videoed this particular circumstance that I'm about to tell you about. So this story I'm telling you is on a YouTube video as well. You can search it. It happened a year ago probably. I'm at the pool. I'm hanging out, relaxing, minding my own business because I'm in my 30s. These girls are 18, 19 years old. They're drinking alcohol, obviously, whatever. I don't know how old they are. I didn't ask them. I said, hey, you wouldn't happen to have a bottle opener, would you? As a matter of fact, I do. Pulled out my bone opener, allowed them to use it, showed them how it works. Oh my goodness, that's amazing. That's so cool. What's going on in these girls' minds right now? They're linking me with being a provider and a protector because I actually invented these tools, okay? But you don't have to have invented them. You just have to understand that you how to use them and then carry them. And that girl's gonna link you with being a provider and a protector. Oh, this guy's got the EDC game figured out. He carries things if I'm safe with him. He knows how to fight. He's got a keychain that could save my life in an extreme scenario. He carries this knife. It's completely concealed, so it's not scary. Nobody knows about it around us. But if he had to use it, he could use it. He knows how to use it. Girls, they're gonna take a sigh of relief, take a little bit of confidence from that. So guys, something like this is on my website for $35 right now. okay? Solid stainless steel chain, solid stainless steel blade, you know, completely usable reverse grip, normal grip, right-handed, left-handed. There's no reason that everybody in the world shouldn't have a knife like this. It'll last forever, and it's amazing. The value is insane. Handmade sheath, it doesn't get any better. It's the most effective and affordable knife in the world, point blank, period. So when you're looking at being a protector, you don't just carry something like that. You have to learn how to use it, understand how to use it. Go to the gym, guys. Train with a trained professional. Train martial arts. Watch these videos, take notes, get this stuff, and figure it out and practice it, guys, okay? Number five. What do you guys think number five is gonna be? Comment below if you can guess number five or number six. But number five is girls want a man who's athletic, okay? Again, subconscious, it's all subconscious. It comes from being able to outrun the lion. That guy that can outrun the lion, he's gonna live longer. Your kid, the woman's kids are gonna live longer if the husband can outrun the lion. Subconscious, how does it manifest itself in today's society? Women want that guy who's athletic. How are you gonna see that? Well, in my experience, back in the day when I used to do the bar and the club scene, I was that guy that was 6'3", 250 and could dance. Okay, I've got moves, I've got rhythm, I can dance salsa, bachata, okay, it doesn't matter, hip-hop dancing, I worked as a bouncer in the club, I'm moving when the music's going, walking through the club, and it's like, oh, you very rarely see a guy who's tall, handsome, and can dance. Just off looks, it sets you apart. Learn how to dance, guys, go take dance classes. You're gonna meet girls in the dance classes. Doesn't matter if you can dance or not, that's what the dance classes are about. Go take some salsa classes, okay? Bachata is the easiest dance to do in the world. I don't even know if they have classes for it, but try it. Try it out. Go to the, you know, to the Latin spot and do the dance classes. Even line dancing at the country bar, it doesn't matter. If you develop some movement, some rhythm, then it's going to be a big help for you. Girls don't want a guy who's clumsy and, you know, bumping and dropping and doing all the stuff like that. Trained, okay? It's trained versus untrained, and it doesn't manifest itself the way that we think it does. Girls aren't watching your shooting videos or martial arts videos on YouTube, but they are noticing whether you're an athlete or not. Being that guy who's athletic and has rhythm is subconsciously telling a girl a couple things. Other than the fact that it's subconsciously telling them you have good genes, it may even be consciously telling them that sexual intercourse with you is going to be better, is going to be good. You know, it's not like riding a bike, guys. It's something that I would say, in my opinion, and I'm going to recommend saving that for marriage, because it, like I've told you many times, it's unfulfilling. You give every one of these girls you have sex with a little piece of yourself, and when I finally meet my wife, it's going to be difficult for me to explain to her why I've had sex with so many women, and it's going to be difficult for me to go. I'm being very personal right here and sharing something about myself, because, you know, at this point with you guys, with my fans, followers, I've kept it real from day one, and, you know, I got a lot of haters, a lot of people talking crap, but one of the things that I'm most known for and always have been and always will be is being one of the realest dudes that people know, and probably the realest dude on YouTube. And if you know me personally, everybody that knows me, you know, that's probably the biggest thing that I get is just, you keep it real, even when it's possibly detrimental to me. So that's something that I struggle with, guys. And I don't want you guys using this to try and just go hook up with women, because it's only going to hurt you in the long run. So please take that from me. Take it from somebody who's been there, done that, lived the club scene. On this note of hooking up with women, okay? This guy even got me a rape charge, guys. I was in the club dancing one night, having a good time. A chick that I had met off Tinder came up there to see me. I'm bouncing, I'm working security, I'm roving the floor, dance with her a little bit. She's trying to make out with me. I'm like, look, you know, I'm working, I can't do this. Let's go upstairs. Oh yeah, okay, let's do it. I would F you right now, she tells me. My goodness, I'm in the mindset at that point in time, not living a good life. I go over and talk to head of security there. I'm moonlighting at this club. I'm basically working there for fun. That's the low point that I've hit in my life. I enjoy just working at the club and hooking up with these random women. It's a five-level club, so I take the chick up to the top level that's not being used, and we hook up. We have sex at the club. I've only seen her I don't even think I've ever seen her before. We linked on Tinder. I may have seen her one time before at the club, but we've never hung out, nothing like that. We've been texting, that's it. I may have seen her once before at the club. I don't think so. I think this is the first time we've actually hung out. We go upstairs, have sex, come back down. Her friends find out. She ends up being married, Mormon, and then she reports it as a rape, and just snowballs from there. I start getting investigated for a lot of other stuff. They bring up a whole bunch of stuff from my past. Then, you know, I get put in a black site prison in Germany. You know, it just snowballed out of control. What happened? Literally just living the fast life and had sex with some chick who wanted a quick hookup. And then when her friends find out, she screams rape because she's married. Did I know she was married? No, she didn't tell me she was married. I matched with her on Tinder. You know what I'm saying? So that's kind of just something that is a little thought for you guys. Don't use this to just hook up with chicks. It's not worth it, I'm telling you. But, you know, take it from somebody who's been there. I want to help you guys that are having a hard time, you know, maybe meeting girls or awkward with women. I want to help you guys, you know, get a date. There's nothing wrong with going on dates, okay? Be respectful to women. Don't look for the sex. If the girl is, now I'm at that level in my life when I go out, it's almost like the sex is, everything moves towards sex regardless if I go out on a date with a girl. And I'm trying to figure out how I can change back into being, you know, through church and trying to, you know, get my relationship right with God, how I can change the way that I think about women and my dating game to find somebody that's going to be, you know, a positive influence on my future, somebody who will be, you know, a good woman and an eventual wife. But that's why I'm telling you guys, don't do the crazy stuff. But let's continue on into number 6, the final one. You guys may have guessed it. If you're funny, then you can really just, if you can make a girl laugh, you'll get the phone number, you'll get the date, you'll get a new friend, you'll have that person in your life, okay? You'll have that social connection, guys. And really, all you need out of all of these things is number 1 and number 6. If you're confident and you can have a girl laughing, the ice is broken, and you control the conversation, you control the situation. Women just want that, you know, that connection at the end of the day. They want somebody that can, you know, they have that fight or flight response, okay, like any of us do. So when you approach with confidence, it's gonna go one of two ways. Number 1 is approach with confidence, but it's gonna go one of two ways. It's either, they're either gonna be into you, or they're gonna have that, it's gonna be the flight response, like think of it, they're gonna be scared. Look at, they'll almost have like a prey animal in the natural kingdom response, like this guy's trying to, you know, going too hard, okay? That's the negative if you're confident, but if you come with confidence and humor, okay? Then it's an icebreaker. So then you're just vibing, okay? You're vibing with that female and things are going well. You have a new friend, you have a social connection. Guys, don't be a weirdo, you know? Dress normal. You don't have to dress over the top, but just wear some normal clothes, okay? You don't wear the full tactical kit. Don't go crazy, just baseline. You can shop at Goodwill, it doesn't matter, okay? Girls are gonna look for that style, well-dressed, name brand stuff, but you can wear jeans that are plain unmarked jeans and a plain unmarked polo shirt and some nice white shoes that they don't know the brand of, or black with a black belt. You know what I mean? Guys, you're there. You look fine. If you're fit, then you beat it. You got those clothes from Walmart, you got those clothes from Goodwill, it doesn't matter. You're approaching with confidence, you approach then with a little bit of humor, and you're in there. If you're not a funny person, study the funny people around you. Use their same stuff. That's what stand-up comedians do. They steal. Nothing, no jokes are new anymore, okay? Look up some jokes online and try them out, and just be confident with those jokes. Have a couple. Memorize them. You got, guys, also something I can tell you is when I was doing my whole, you know, dating and, you know, doing a lot of dating and hanging out with a lot of women, something that even at my prime of doing that, of having, you know, having sex at the club, when I'm working at the club with 1 or 2 women a night at the club and then hanging out with other women when I got out of work, okay, terrible lifestyle. But one thing that I learned is that it's going back to the predator-prey analogy that I gave you guys. And guys are basically like this, very similar to the animal kingdom when they're out looking for a mate. And we're more intelligent, so now we're looking for dating, and we're not looking for just sex like I'm talking about here with you guys, but the basic idea is the same. So women are gonna go, you know, one of two ways. There's gonna be a complete shutdown or you're gonna get it. But the interesting thing is that the statistics of predators is predators always, every predator in the world, sharks, lions, every single predator in the world misses more kills, misses more opportunities. They are not successful. There's no successful predators, okay? Whether it's 40% success rate, whether it's 30, 10, 5, 49, there's none that have 50% or above. So you can't expect to have that either. So with that in mind, don't get discouraged and work on your success rate. Try and get it up to 49%. I would say that that would be the maximum that you could have of a success rate with talking to women and having a good social connection would be 4 out of 10, okay? But I would say that 1 out of 10 for most guys is a big win, okay? So there's a lot of guys that 1 out of 100 is something that they're happy with. So approach with confidence, approach with humor, don't be discouraged, bone out.